loves, I'm back today again with another tutorial. And if you know me, I'm normally in a wife beater with some jeans. So today I'm actually gonna do my go-to look for my eyeshadow. Something really quick and easy. This is probably gonna be one of my simpler and easier tutorials. When I'm in a rush and I'm on the go, this is what I will generally go to. So let's begin. So here it goes. This is my look. And I want you to know I will be looking to the side because that's where my mirror is. Or at least what I'm using as a mirror. So I'm going to start and fill in my eyebrows with MAC Spike. So I just filled in my eyebrows. I got them done today. So they are actually very clean. I like going with my Urban Decay Primer in Original. And I'm just going to put that all over my lid. So it's primed, my eyeshadow has something to stick to. And then also today I'm going to be using MAC's Paint Pot in Indian Wood. And it's kind of like a goldish color. It's really pretty. It's just going to give it right here on my actual lid. Because I just want that color that's going on there to pop a little more. So that is the color. So now I'm going to go on with my highlight color. And for that, I'm using Patina from MAC. It's a very pretty neutral color. And I like it a lot. And I'm going to go right in underneath my brow bone. And since my eyebrows are done, my highlight actually pops a lot more. Which is fabulous for me. Now I'm going in with my transitioning color. For my transitioning color, I'm going to be using MAC's Brown Script. And it's like a brown color with a bit of a red undertone to it. This is my go-to color. It just warms it up a bit, which I love. Now that I laid that down, it kind of goes into my skin to blend it, but just gives it a little warmness. I'm actually going to go back to Patina again, and I'm going to be using it with my Real Techniques brush. And I'm going to lay that as my lid color also. I'm just going to pat that on. And because I did put that base, it's going to make it pop a little more. I actually really like this color. And then I'm going to go back in with my transition color to clean that up. Take it back down a little and blend in the edges. I don't want any sharpness in there. So that's just going to blend it in. Just blend it into my highlight also. So now that that's in, I'm actually going to go in with my blending brush from Sigma. And I'm going in with MAC's color in Contrast. It's a blue with a bit of sparkle in it. It's actually really pretty. It's a bit reflective. I'm going to put it all in there. I'm going to use my blending brush to actually lay it and blend it in at the same time. It's just going into my corner. And since this is a blending brush, once you're laying it at the same time, it's kind of actually blending it in, which is great. Now that's blended in, I'm actually just going to take it up a little and overlay it on my crease. All that's doing is giving me a little bit more depth. It's not too heavy. And that actually is my finished eyeshadow look. Now I'm going to go in, of course, you know, with my iStudio, and I'm going in with my brush, and I'm going to lay my liner down. Nothing too dramatic. My eyeshadow laid down. Now that that's done, I'm going in with CoverGirl's mascara and Clump Crusher by Lash Blast. I actually like the wand on this. It's actually a bit curved. And this is just going to separate it, make sure it's not clumped. But this is a very good everyday mascara. I have to say. And now my eyes are actually all done. I have a little blush. I have foundation on already. Very light with a little blush. And then this is my go-to lipstick, which is actually empty almost, or basically empty. And it's Fig Jam. I don't think you can see it. You can see it somewhat, but it's really pretty. And it's just going to give my color, my lips a little bit of color. See, it's nothing major, just a little bit of tint of color to it. And that is actually my finished go-to look. So if you're ever going anywhere just for the day, if you want your quick go-to look that is simple and easy, this is what I would suggest doing. Not too many colors, not too busy. Gives you the right amount of pop without going overboard. And I hope you liked this video. And if you did like, please like it and subscribe. And thank you, loves. Bye until next time.